Hello and welcome to another episode of Better You Life Coaching. I'm your host, Dre. And for today's topic, we're going to be talking about what is credit. Credit is whenever a person decides to purchase a product or service, et cetera, with money that they don't currently possess. Or with simplest terms, money that's not theirs. That's what's meant by extending credit. When you get an unsecured credit card, that money is not your money. That's the bank's money, and the bank is allowing you to use their money and basically pay them back. The best way to kind of dumb it down and think about it is credit in your score. It's very similar to how we do with our family and friends. There are certain folks that we know if we give them money, we ain't never getting that money back. And there's certain folks we know if they ever need anything, we'll basically give them the shirt off our back because they've always showed up for us. Basically, if they make us a promise, they follow through on it. It kind of to go back to the first example, we all know people in our lives that if they make a promise to us, that promise is shaky at best. And those are the type of people, just in terms of relating it back to the credit score, those are the type of people who would have a very low credit score, have trouble being extended credit. These would be your people like sub 500, subprime, probably not even subprime, just straight bad credit. These are the people who banks view as being very flaky and an investment risk. So essentially, if they extend credit, it's going to come with very odious terms because, frankly, they don't trust you to pay that money back because your track record's not good. Vice versa. On the other end, we all know folks who, when they make us a promise, their word is as good as gold. Come to us, either they've already done it or it's about to happen. And the thing about this and how it relates to how we think about credit is, we could think of our credit score in essence as how good is our name? How good is our standing? In terms of financial purposes with various banks, because when it comes to credit is very important in today's modern society. Credit is going to determine if you're able to get that house or not, if you're able to get that car or not. I mean, even being able to make certain large purchases. If your credit score isn't at least in a subprime range, you're probably not even going to get credit extended to you. So that's one thing to keep in mind. So I know things can get kind of difficult, and it's easy to let some bills kind of go or slide by the wayside, but all of that has an impact, and all of that's going to affect you, and it can follow you for years after the fact. And the thing about it is, if your credit score is good, then a couple of negative remarks can really do damage to you. I mean, if your credit score is already trash, you know, somebody's like, I'm going to put you in collections. I'm at a 400. What you going to do? You know? So with that out the way, in terms of understanding what credit is and why we would need credit, there are certain things to keep in mind when we look at our credit score. Now, there's two different scoring models. I'm going to stick primarily to the FICO model since that's the one that's used by the majority of lenders and creditors out there. If I get a comment or whatever, and somebody's really interested in Advantage, I will break down Advantage. But just know that You have what's called FICO, and you have what's called Vantage. And basically, they do essentially the same thing, but your scores can be different because the items that they weigh in their score calculation are weighted at different percentages. So, first off, in terms of credit scores, you've probably heard TransUnion, Equifax, and Experian before. Those are the three major credit bureaus. So, essentially, the way your credit score is tabulated, each of these bureaus gets information from a creditor. So, say if you go to a bank, take out a loan, you get a credit card, whatever that would report on your credit. What they do is that that creditor reports that information to one or more of those bureaus, and that goes on your credit report. And at the end of each month, when that cycle closes, that information basically sends a snapshot to the credit bureaus of your account. And from there, the summation of your entire credit report is what spits out your score and gives you that three-digit rating. For the FICO model, the first part of your credit score is going to be your payment history. Roughly 35% of your FICO score is going to be payment history. So this is basically, had you made your payments on time and how long? Essentially, the best is 100. And 99% is typically considered good. That's essentially, you know, if you missed a payment somewhere along the way. Late payments are grouped into 30, 60, 90, 120, and then charge off. And essentially, the later a payment goes on an account, well, a later an account goes without being paid, rather, the more harsh the impact is going to be on your credit report. So in terms of making sure that your credit score is the best it can be, the foundation of it is making sure that all your bills are paid on time. Second, 30% of your score is going to be your utilization. Now, there's two utilization. You can think of utilization as a ratio to your available credit and credit used. So you have what's called an individual utilization ratio. So for instance, if I have a credit card and I have a $5,000 limit on it, if I'm using $500 of that, it's going to say that my credit utilization is 10%. And you know, conversely, if I was using like $4,500 of it, it's going to say it's at 90%. You have a utilization for all of your unsecured accounts overall, and then you have your individual card utilizations. So that's something to keep in mind. A general rule of thumb when it comes to utilization is keep your accounts at 30% or below. In my personal experience, I feel that my score has been maximized by keeping my accounts at roughly sub 10%. So I carry very small balances. I try to keep only about roughly 5% or less rolling from month to month. And that's really just so that payments can be reported. Because otherwise, if you pay everything down to zero, you can actually see a slight dip in your credit score simply because there won't be any payments being made. And so sometimes it is beneficial to leave just like a small balance, like a $5, $10, basically just go to Chick-fil-A or whatever and let that report and pay it. I mean, and then from there, you have the length of your credit history. So this is how old are your credit accounts. This is 15% of your credit score. Essentially, you're getting into the excellent range once your accounts are up beyond 10 years plus. Since it's only 15% of your credit score, especially for somebody who may be new, like someone fresh out of college or high school who's just getting themselves established, unless you're piggybacking off of like a parent's account, this is probably going to be fairly new for you. And it takes time to build this up. But once again, it's one of the smaller parts of your credit. You know, the payment history and utilization make up 65% of your score. So if you, this is one that you can't really help too much, but don't drive yourself crazy and insane if your credit, length of credit history isn't that long. Next, 10% is your credit mix. So this is how many different types of credit accounts do you have? Creditors are generally looking to see how you handle different types of debt. So mortgage debt, unsecured credit cards, personal lines of credit, personal loans, so on and so forth. Basically, if you have a few different types of debt, this is going to score fairly well for you. And once again, it's 10%. So in the grand scheme of things, not too terribly high impacting on your credit score. Finally, we have inquiries, which is the final 10% of your FICO score. Inquiries is how many times somebody has hard pulled your credit. So a hard pull is when somebody goes and actually pings a credit bureau and pulls your credit report. It's not the same as a soft pull where essentially they don't actually ping the bureau, but rather just kind of tap into an electronic service to see what your information is. Inquiries can get a little tricky. Generally, with each new inquiry, you're going to see an initial hit to your account. See, not your account, but your credit score. It can vary a little bit, anywhere from 2 to 5 points. The thing with inquiries is they can raise a red flag for creditors, because if you are, say for instance, if you're pursuing a lot of inquiries in a short amount of time, it can raise a flag and makes you look like you essentially you have some type of financial emergency and that you are trying to get some money to float through a situation and you may not be able to pay the creditors back their money. So be aware of that. So like if you find yourself in a situation where you're getting denied, you know, pull up for a little bit and try to see if there's another means to getting out of that situation. Because if you putting in massive inquiries, like I know some folks who've put in like 15, 20 inquiries at one point in time, that's going to ding your score each and every time there's a hard pull. And 2 to 5 points isn't a lot, but when you get into those crazy high inquiry numbers, that can have an impact. And then on top of that, it can also, even if you would otherwise qualify, it can raise a red flag so that credit would be denied. And those are the items that make up your credit report. Another thing to keep in mind is negative remarks. So these are going to be kind of fall in line with the late payments, but any type of negative remark on your account. So basically late payments and charge-offs. Charge-offs, late payments, those things are gonna weigh against your credit score. And typically with charge-offs, or collection accounts rather, you're gonna see where your credit score is gonna get the biggest hit within the first couple of years, those first 2 to 3 years, then it's gonna start the rebound. There are a lot of different ways that you can get collections off of your account. There's pay for deletes. You can always dispute and check the credit report and see if anything is invalid with that debt and pursue removal of it that way. And then finally, you can always, if you don't feel comfortable disputing your debts yourself, or you can always go to a third party like a credit repair professional and seek out their advice and have them do that work on your behalf. But that's pretty much it. That's what is credit. In a nutshell, credit is no different than what the standing of your name is. Is your name good out here in these streets? That's the best way to kind of think of it on a personal terms. I think sometimes we can kind of build things up into these uber complex systematic structures. But essentially, are you good for it? If somebody were to come and, you know, you ask them for money, would they say that, hey, your name is good in these streets? Or would they say that, I ain't got it? So a little bit of food for thought. Hope you enjoy this one. It's been a pleasure. If, as always, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, thumbs up, thumbs down if you didn't like it. Thank you, and hope you have a great one. Peace. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me.